Hi there, it's Cindy Powers Prosser, and I'm here to help you to become really responsible for your future. Like, you get to create your future. You get to choose which future timeline you want to take off on. There's a lot of options here, and there's a lot of unknown happening, and I think that many of us are going to be having different futures depending on our beliefs and our thoughts. So I am here to help you to be really clear with what you are giving attention to and how you can consciously create the future of your desired, not what you're worried about. I don't want you to create your biggest fear into a reality. I want you to create your biggest desired future into a reality. And you actually have that, that possibility to do that. And so let me give you 8 steps on consciously creating your future. The first step is to look, well, I guess there's 9 steps. The first step that I wasn't counting is to really look at what you're fearful of. Is it true? Look at your fears and look at your beliefs around those fears and pull them apart and see if they're really true. Now, if there's something you can do, an action you can take to eliminate that fear, do that. If there's more information you can gather to see if that fear is actually true, I highly recommend that you do your due diligence in gathering information right now around all kinds of things that are out there that the media is telling us, or anything, social media is telling us. Do your due diligence and make sure you have the facts and feel into with your intuition whether this feels in alignment with you or not. Okay, now let's get into the 8 steps of conscious creation. After you get rid of the fears, or at least do what you can to dismiss them as much as possible, you want to get clear with what it is you desire. Your desire is in your heart. And what is that future that you desire? Write that down in present tense as if it's already happening. All right. Number 2, using your active imagination, feel into what it feels like to live that desired future. Engaging your senses, hear what you want to hear, feel what you want to feel, smell what you want to smell, be in the future, in your active imagination, be in the future you desire in the present moment. So be in it, in your body, in your active imagination, and really live it in your imagination, in your body. Powerful, powerful tool. Can you see how we often do that with fear? Do it with your desire. Number 3. Expect this or something better with harm to none. And number 4, let go of all attachments to the details. Remember, attachments are out there. So any attachment to when is it going to happen, with whom is it going to happen, how is it going to happen, all of those attachments in your 3D reality, remember, it's a feeling over a form. You want to feel into the expansiveness of your future, okay? And so you can play with the form. You can see specific people or situations, but don't be attached to them. Allow that form to engage the feeling, but then let go of the form and just be in the feeling of what it feels like when you're in your desired future, okay? So let go, release all attachments. The second one is, keep it to your, I mean, the second one, the, is that the fifth one? I think that's the fifth one. Keep it to yourself. Don't share it with a lot of people. Don't talk to too many people, especially people that don't want your highest or best future for you. It's a personal thing, and you don't want other people to dampen it down with their beliefs or fears or, you can't make that happen. That's not possible. Don't go there. Believe in yourself and keep it to yourself, and only share this with people you trust. Keep your vibe high, okay? Do what you love, love what you do. Spend time around people that inspire you. Spend time in nature. I write a lot about this, so you know what I'm talking about. When you have to be productive, do it with joy. You have a choice. You can do it with martyrdom or, you know, drudgery, or you can do it with joy. Do all things with joy. It matters so much. Keep your vibe high. Then let things come with you in divine timing. You don't want to hold on to a timeline. You want to allow the timeline to come to you. You want to allow it to flow and to unfold with ease and grace. So don't try to push the river. Let it flow. And be open to all possibilities and opportunities. That's really important. You may be looking over here and thinking that's what's going to show up for you, but actually it could be over here. It could be a completely different choice that you hadn't even considered. But be open to learning. Stay curious and continue to gather information and ask questions, because you may not know what is meant to be yours. And until you open up to different possibilities and opportunities and gather information and look at different options and choices, you may miss out what the best is yet to be. Okay, so stay high, desire, dream, live in that active imagination in your body, and expect this or something better with harm to none. Release all attachment to anything out there, and trust in the process. Keep your vibe high. It matters. All right, that's all for now. Reach out, ask any questions below if you have any questions for me, and I'll be back again with more. Love to you. Bye-bye.